And now for the third installment in our Business of Birth series that has been running across the BBC all this week. And today, we turn to India and the controversial topic of stem cell banking. Well, the use of stem cells is still being researched, but in the future, it's expected that these cells, which are our master cells, will be used to treat a host of genetic disorders and to help rebuild damaged tissues. Some companies are taking advantage of that and are making good money by offering to bank stem cells. But is this money well spent when the benefits are still unclear? Suranjana Tiwari went to find out.
Moments after entering the world, this baby girl may have already saved another life. Her stem cells are being harvested from the blood in her umbilical cord. Stem cells are already being used to treat some diseases. And with hundreds of trials underway globally, one day they could be used to cure a range of genetic disorders.
This is the best time to harvest stem cells rather than a painful procedure later in life. And because of the size of India's population, there's huge potential for stem cell banking. But more people need to do what's happening here. India accounts for 20% of the world's population, but less than 1% of stem cell donors come from here.
That means the chances of Indians finding a suitable match are extremely low. Awareness is growing, though. India's largest bank, LifeCell, has a customer base of 250,000 people. 50,000 of them signed up last year alone. And as the business expands, prices have come down. It costs just over $1,000 to have cells collected and stored at this facility for 75 years. But that's still a high cost for the average Indian, especially when the chances of being able to use your own stem cells for treatment are less than 0.01%.
So far, the stem cells were being preserved by the family for their own private use. The benefit was only limited to the baby, but now we've made a model where parents can share their stem cells with the community at large. And what that does is increases the benefit to not just the baby, but also the baby's sibling, baby's parents, and also the baby's grandparents. So it's a multifold increase in benefit.
Experts agree that sharing stem cells in a bank will increase the chances of finding a donor exponentially. The concept of community banking encouraged first-time parents Swapnil and Pooja to bank their baby stem cells.
We decided to go for the stem cell thing, and we are very lucky that, you know, we are doing something good for my baby. It will definitely help the babies in future.
And although skeptics say the medical science is only in the very early stages, parents are willing to take a chance and pay the price to potentially protect their new arrivals. Suranjana Tiwari, BBC News, Mumbai.
And join us in the conversation online. We're asking whether stem cell banking is a